Hi all, welcome to my super learning channel. Dear friends, wishing you all a very happy new year. Let's get started. So today we are going to see how to use the 3D viewer application, which is a Microsoft app that is available from the Microsoft Store. So as soon as you log into the application, you will see a sample demonstration of 3D modeling. This is primarily used for modeling purpose of any images that you want to view from different perspectives. Okay, so for example, here is a bee that is flapping his wings. So if I want to have the shadow, if I click the campfire one, the particular theme shows the shadow of this. If I click the cotton candy, this is another theme. You could also see the color also turns into different one. And the next one is glow in the dark and so forth. So you can choose whatever themes you want, and the lighting. So if you see, the default lighting is just behind the bee. So I can rotate and make this to anywhere. See, the shadow gets moved based on the lighting rotation. And there are various options available within this software. You can explore more. I'm just giving a quick demonstration of what is available with this 3D viewer software. And if you switch to this tab, which is called Stats and Shading, so you can set this mesh data. If you want to set this vertical triangle, then you can. It could be either triangle or verticals, which is giving a wireframe kind of view. And there are other textures available, which the normal one, and I'm just showing a couple of available ones. If you want to even go to the level of looking at the bone structure, the animation is happening. If you want to switch a different animation mode, you can click this and change between animation 1 to 3. And similarly, so we can also choose quick animations like turnable, so which turns into 360 degree, and if you want to make it swing between right to left, if you want to make the fish jump and turn, if you want to make it hover, so you have lot of options, and you can even control the animation speed. Similarly, you can apply all the themes to visualize how the image looks. And let's get into another tab and see one more example from the inspiration one. I'm choosing the tortoise one. you could see it is giving the 3D perspective of the chosen image. And I'm choosing another one. See, if you want to get more images, you need to download it from the website. There are large number of 3D images available within the website, and you can take from the library. And you can see the unicorn is ready, and again you can change the color and you can see the different perspectives of this 3D image. And if in order to print this, so that's the key activity that I want to brief you. This will take a couple of seconds to get the 3D printing loaded. So this will load the model into the 3D . You can see that the file is getting loaded and it is preparing the object for 3D printing. This will also, so once it is done, it will choose if there are any available printers already for printing this, or otherwise you can also pick the one from online 3D printing service. This will also allow you to choose the material how you want to print. Like if you want to print this image on a steel or a multicolor or resin cloth, and what is the layout that you want to print. I'm just canceling it now. So this is a pretty cool feature that you can explore and have fun. Keep learning and keep sharing. Thanks once again for viewing my Super Learning channel. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not subscribed already, and keep waiting for my upcoming sessions. Thank you. Have a good day.